Hey goddess, it's Abiola Abrams from the Rich Goddess Spiritpreneur Accelerator. All right, so today I'm going to be talking about how to build your guru brand so that you stand out. Now, this was a question that I got from one of the goddesses in my tribe. She basically said, "Dear Abiola, here's the thing. I am training to be a life coach, but everybody and their mother is a life coach. How do I stand out in the world, in the marketplace?" All right, my goddess, you have come to the very right place. First, I have a question for you. Yeah, it may seem like everybody's a life coach, and how do you then stand out when everybody and their mother's a life coach? But everybody's a lawyer and everybody's a doctor too. Why is that? Because all of those lawyers and doctors are needed, just like you and your work as a coach, all right? So this is all gonna come down to how you position yourself in the marketplace, your positioning. First of all, you're not gonna be just some generic old life coach. Why not? Because I'm not gonna let you, that's why. You need to be speaking to a specific group, a specific clientele, a specific niche. What's the niche? Chances are you're the niche. So rather than going general, go very specific. Rather than going wide, go very deep. Now, I know this is very terrifying to entrepreneurs, spiritpreneurs, goddesspreneurs. I know it was terrifying for me, right? But wait, what if I narrow down my audience, you know, narrow down my crowd to just my spiritual goddess gurus? What about the men? What about the other people? What about this? What about the price of tea in China? No, none of that has anything to do with it. You talk to your tribe, and the biggest key to distinguishing who you are in the marketplace is what I like to call WAFP. WAFP. Now, what does that stand for? Be as weird as freaking possible. You can replace it with the expletive of your choice. Yeah, now I don't mean be weird for weird's sake. I mean, give yourself permission to be weird. Give yourself permission to be yourself, to be fully yourself, to be unapologetically yourself. No one can compete with you at you being you. So for example, you know, my Wonder Woman bangles, I've been rocking these since grade school, right? Anybody who knows me knows that, you know, loud earrings, loud hair, loud jewelry is just me, right? In a lot of my videos, you will see, for example, you know, things like my magic wand. Now, I'm not doing that just to be a weirdo. I really am that weirdo, you know? People who are friends of mine, family members of mine can tell you, if they come to my house, you're gonna probably see a magic wand or two. That is who I am, right? So it's not me just putting on something, just putting on airs. Most of us who are, you know, coaches, healers, experts, other gurus, you are building a personal brand. So let it be personal. If you are, you know, some amazing black Nordic Jewish chef who cooks Louisiana cooking in a healthy way, that's awesome. Go deep into that. Be all the way there. No one can beat you at being you. You see what I mean? So when you're very generic, like, okay, I'm just a coach, or I'm just a health coach, or just a whatever, then I could go to you, I could go to her, I could go to whatever. But if I want that black Jewish Louisiana low-fat cooking, I gotta come to you. You see what I'm saying? So be very specific in who you are. Allow yourself to be as weird as freaking possible. And that is the strongest way to build your brand. Combine that with the positioning of speaking to your very specific goddess audiences. You know, like, you can't get, for example, my gurus more specific than, you know, spiritual women who have a big calling that they want to put into the world and, you know, are very into their magical powers. You can't get more specific than that, right? That's my tribe. That's who I talk to, and we rock it together. All right. So that's what I want for you. Instead of going wide, go deep. So leave me in the comments about how you're going to brand yourself. You know, brand is not just the colors, like my hot pink, right? which is definitely a part of, you know, how I show up in the world when you go to my sites. But it is all of the way that people feel when they interact with me as a brand. How do we feel when we interact with you as a brand? That comes from your authenticity and you being WAFP. All right, so make sure you go ahead and put your cute little self into my free Spiritual Business Success Camp. Free Spiritual Business Success Camp with new lessons being uploaded all the time at unblockmybusiness.com. Unblockmybusiness.com. All right, my darling, be seen, be heard, be your own kind of movement. Namaste. Yeah.